Dr. DeGroote, thanks again for joining us here in Practice Update. Can you share with us some of the unique challenges to managing glioblastoma in an elderly patient population?
Absolutely. So as you may know, glioblastoma, the median age of diagnosis is 64. And so over half of our patients are considered to be in the elderly category. I think there's a lot of potential challenges with these patients, in part because of comorbidities. So older patients might have other diseases that could interfere with the treatment or produce greater morbidity. We also know that many of these patients are going to have MGMT promoter unmethylation, which is a poor prognostic factor. And patients tend to, potentially not be able to tolerate the treatment as well. They might be more frail and not be able to sort of receive the full, standard of care that we might give to younger patients.
I see. What kinds of modifications would need to be made to standard treatment in this patient population?
Sure. One of the approaches that have been pursued is to actually shorten the course of radiation. So patients are treated with hypofractionated radiation that might occur over 3 or 4 weeks. And then we also might not give the patient, an elderly patient, temozolomide during the radiation. We do know from some recent studies just recently published in the New England Journal that actually using radiation and Temodar together in a hypofractionated setting is better than radiation alone in the elderly patient population. But I think it's difficult to apply that to all patients because we do have some who are just too frail or who have a poor performance status and really aren't able to tolerate those therapies.
Aside from that data that you just presented as far as how we can guide treatment approaches, is there any other data to guide treatment approach in this patient setting?
Yeah, so there's a lot of interest and there have been many studies looking at this patient population to, number one, use the therapy that prolongs life, but also is, more tolerable. And so there have been studies that have looked at radiation alone, but also temozolomide alone. And so in some centers, we test MGMT promoter methylation up front, and if they are methylated patients and more likely to benefit from temozolomide, then they may just receive temozolomide alone. And that's a strategy that's really frequently pursued in parts of Europe, but also is done here in the U.S.
That's good to know. And then based on your research overall, do you think that age should be used as a basis for treatment de-escalation?
I think it's difficult. My typical approach is to not use chronologic age, but to use biologic age. Mm-hmm. And by that, I just mean, we see many older patients who are living very well, even into their 70s and 80s. And so I tend to not use an age cutoff, but if their performance score is very good and they seem very strong and able to receive the full treatment that I actually recommend going with the standard of care that we would give to younger patients.
That's excellent to know. Thank you so much for sharing your expertise. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.